Definitely watch this video before you hire your next whitetail habitat consultant. Hi, this is Matt with Genesis Custom Food Plots. Today's video is going to be focused on a bit of a family meeting around the topic of whitetail habitat consultants. As you might expect in the line of work that we're in, we have a lot of people coming to us with a variety of plans that have been written from a variety of consultants all over the country. In fact, if you go on Google right now and you simply just Google whitetail habitat consultants, that list is getting longer and longer and longer by the day. The number of plans that we're seeing is growing exponentially. The problems that we're seeing, unfortunately, are many. In this video, we want to talk through a lot of those problems and help you avoid some of the pitfalls that we see on our end when it comes to actually implementing the plans that many of these consultants are putting out. All right, so let's start with the number one pitfall that we see in our business, and that is this discussion of budget. When you're hiring a whitetail habitat consultant, far too often the budget discussion starts and stops with how much money do you have to pay a consultant to come onto your property and give you a plan. And that's the end of the budget discussion. If the budget discussion does not continue, how much is your budget to continue to maintain the plan? Here's how much it's gonna cost me to come and visit you over the long term. And if that discussion isn't being had, that is not a consultant that you should be hiring. Within the last month, we had a plan come to us from a consultant that you've all heard of. We got the plan. It was a beautiful plan. It was a great map. It was a great write-up, all of those things. We met with the customer. They were going to start the implementation of that. There was food plots. There was logging. There was excavating and dozer work and access and all the things that you would expect in a good plan. The problem is nobody had ever talked to them about the cost to actually implement that plan. A lot of the consultants have never done the work. They don't know how to do the work. They don't know what it's going to take to do it. So when we show up to start talking about the implementation, it doesn't take long to get to, holy smokes, we don't have the budget for this. And that's exactly what happened with this family. They had spent $3,000 for a consultant to come out. We were there 45 minutes and literally had arrived very quickly that they just don't have the budget to build or maintain everything in this plan. So we ended up rewriting the plan into something that fit their budget. I felt terrible because they had spent $3,000 with this consultant. But at the end of the day, the $3,000 wasn't worth very much because they couldn't do very much of what was in there. And we ended up having to rework that plan to make it affordable for them. Issue number two, which is very closely related to point number one, which is the budget, is the concept of time. We see a ton of plans that are really well written, really good maps, really good information in them. And regrettably, one of the things that's not discussed is if you're going to put in the totality of that plan, how much time is required to do it? I don't think it's a tough leap to figure out why that conversation isn't being had. The reality is the majority of the habitat consultants out there have never actually sat in a seat and gone out and operated equipment that's necessary to clear an access trail, to go and clear food plots, actually go out and implement a plan that they've drawn up. So subsequently, they wouldn't know how much time it takes. Well, just a couple of weeks ago, we had a potential customer come to us. They had a very well-known consultant, again, write up a plan. He and his buddy actually happens to be an equipment operator. So the consultant told them, listen, you can go and get all of these things cleared. You've got a buddy that can do it. Go and rent some equipment and come in and get it done. And they were kind of scratching their head. They were a little skeptical, but they thought, okay, well, we'll look into this. Well, what nobody told them was the nearest rental facility was over 2 hours away where they could get a piece of equipment. They were looking at $1,000 to $1,500 just to get the equipment there and back from the rental facility because they had no way to pick it up. Then they're looking at their plan. It's about 5 acres of clearing. No way you're getting that done in a weekend. They're looking at a multiple week rental for this piece of equipment. All of a sudden they're going, wait a minute, this doesn't fit our budget. Now we're back to number one. We should maybe call somebody and see if they can help us. So they called us. We went and met with them, looked at the project. And in fact, it was a big project to get done. Clearing 5 acres is not a weekend thing. We were right back to the budget discussion. So we ended up rewriting that plan, getting them into something that was more budget friendly to them, more time friendly to them. We're gonna actually end up doing some work for them, but it's not gonna look anything like the plan that the consultant wrote up for them, simply because it didn't fit their budget and it didn't fit their time frame. Pitfall number three, we're gonna put a blanket on, call it timber stand improvement and forestry work. The reality is for most landowners, your forest land represents 80, 90% of your land. That other 10, 20% is food plots, grasses. Everybody seems to be an expert on those things. Different video on that for a different day. Let's talk about three of the major issues we see in the forest work side of this business. Number one is tree identification. It's a huge part of any plan that gets written up. Any type of clear cutting, whether you're doing hinge cutting, it's important to know what species of trees that you're working on and how they're going to respond when you do something. We had a plan come into us here recently from a consultant that had prescribed an aspen clear cut, great way to regenerate aspen. We went in to look at it with the customer. The whole stand is maples, and we're left to stand there and have a really awkward conversation about how much did you pay for this advice? Avoid that. Number two, we see a lot of intricate cutting plans, pocket cuts and little polka dot areas and lanes. The reality of that is if you ask a logger to go in and do that, they're probably gonna laugh at you. There's just no economical way for a logger to come in and do it. So we circle right back to our first couple of pitfalls. You're either gonna have a budget to pay somebody to do it, or you're gonna have to have the time to do it yourself. So it's not that they're bad ideas, but have a realistic expectation of what it's gonna take to get those types of intricate cuts done. Number three is this thought that if I'm gonna do a large scale logging project, I'm going to get a big enough check to help me offset a big chunk of my costs for the rest of the development of the property. The reality is now that's probably not true. Timber markets are very, very bad unless you have some kind of high value tree like a black walnut. The reality is we see a lot of landowners that are getting large scale work done. They're getting small checks, but all too often we're seeing a lot of landowners that are saying, hey, I didn't have to pay my logger, but my logger didn't pay me, but I got my habitat work done and that worked out pretty well. So make sure you're having thorough conversations with your consultant about their background in forestry and the amount of work that they've done so they can give you the best advice possible. So the goal with all of the videos that we produce is to provide you content that will make you a better consumer when it comes to managing your hunting land. This topic of whitetail habitat consultants, we've just scratched the surface barely. There are more and more consultants coming to the market every single day, and the unfortunate part is there's a lot of them that aren't very good at it. They're either repeating information that they've heard from somebody else or just from other videos that they've watched. Where the rubber meets the road is what actually happens in the field. So if you've got questions about a consultant, if you're thinking about hiring somebody, or if you'd like to talk to us about doing some consulting for you, feel free to email us. Drop us a comment below in this video. We'll be happy to follow up with you and we'll help you out the best that we can. In the meantime, we appreciate you taking the time to watch today. Please take a moment to like and subscribe, and we will see you on our next video.